Assalamualaikum and annyeonghaseyo guys. So for today, do you know where I am right now? Well, this is our Putra Mosque in Putrajaya. This is one of the famous tourist spot in Malaysia, and it is located just beside the Perdana Putra, which is our Malaysia's Prime Minister main office. And over there is our Putrajaya Lake, which is a man-made lake. And also over there in front of the mosque is our large square with flagpoles flying our Malaysia state flag. And during the weekend, lots of family will be gathered here, maybe well especially at night, to spend time with their family. And for today's video, I'm going to show you guys our mosque inside and explain to you guys about our mosque. So stay tuned for today's video.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okey, penggunaan jubah ni diberikan kepada orang yang bukan muslim, non muslim. Kalau pancur datang ke datang sini, kita beri jubah untuk supaya aurat ditutup lah. Selain pada itu, kita bagi iat pada orang muslim daripada pakaian, pakai pakaian ketat, kita bagi dia jubah. Itu sahaja daripada saya. Sekian, terima kasih.
Can see that this is one of the example of our mosque interior design. So now it's after the lunch hour and after the Zuhur prayer, and you can see that there's a lot of foreign tourists lining up waiting to get the jubah.
So can you introduce
your,
about yourself a little bit?
Okay, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Raja Aman Shah bin Raja Sabah Zaman. I'm the representative of Islamic Outreach Abim Center as the mosque tour guide for this Masjid Putra. This is my 10th year as a volunteer, and we encourage more people to join us to become volunteers here as to how we can convey the true message of Islam to the other faith.
So could you tell us, like, one day how many tourists come for one day?
It's very subjective. It depends on peak hours and also holidays, right, from their countries as well. But last year we clocked about almost 1 million. And 80% is from China actually, and then Vietnamese, Japanese and so forth. But daily we will expect minimum of 1,000, maybe going upwards to maximum of 5,000.
That's a lot. And now, do you have like anything you want to explain about this mosque, like the specialty of this mosque, anything?
Okay, basically what is different between this masjid and other masjid in Malaysia? The concept of architecture is more towards the Middle East, so probably about 80% complied to the Persian architecture during the Safavi era, and also we have the Egyptian on the domes, which is flower motif on that, and the retaining wall coming from the King Hassan from Casablanca, and also we have the minaret which resemble the Chioma Mosque in Baghdad in Iraq. So it's a combination of a lot of the Middle East country, which is slightly different from the other masjid in Malaysia. And architect is a local Malaysian, Nick Muhammad bin Mahmud from Seni Reka Samarhat. The main contractor is the Sabi Miladin Group from Saudi Arabia. Right? So most of the materials are imported. And you can see that we have the only mukanas, four big mukanas inside the mosque, where it resembles chapter 35 of the verses of the Quran. Chapter 35, verse 45, it talks about lights, right? And then also the dome and everything, the stained glass coming from Europe actually, from Germany. And the idea of this mosque, the concept is to have a lot of good ventilation, right? So in other words, that's why the concept is we do not enclose the whole building. We use sliding doors so that we can open up all the sliding doors to allow all the wind to come in all direction. And we use a lot of plaster ceiling or limestone that will help to cool down the mosque, the marbles and the granite as well. And also 90% of this mosque is sitting on water, which is a man-made lake of 650 hectares. And it allows also to cool down the mosque. But on Friday, we have about 6,000 worshippers coming, right? So we still need the air condition system. And basically over here, you can see all the air condition systems are being fitted to each of the pillars. Right? So it will be more comfortable. And the lighting system is quite unique in the sense that if you look at the lighting system at the pillars, they are all upwards rather than downwards. Right? So this is quite unique. And also from the mukanas, you can see the lighting system going outwards again to reflect it to the glass and to give you the star. Right? So if you probably extract the verses of the Quran for these mukanas, you will say that Allah is the light of the heaven and the earth. The stimuli of the light as if it was in a niche. You can see the niche there. And where there is a lamp and the lamp is the glass below. And then the glass as if it's like a brilliant star. Right? So this is right? And then you can see the flower motif on the walls here to probably talk about food, right? So again in the verses of the Quran, Allah mentioned that I send down the rainwater from the sky for the various crops to grow. So crops can be the food, okay? To symbolize the food as well. Okay? And then of course the mihrab is very unique because in most of the mosques, we have the calligraphy either in Nazak or Tuluf, but we have Kufi here, right, in the center of Surah Al-Baqarah 144, okay? And then also at the other side of the wall, right, chapter 27, right, which talks about how Prophet Solomon thanked Allah for the good life that was given to him and his parents. Okay. So you can see the flower motif from Morocco, from itself, from Marrakesh, and how they do it.
I see, that's very interesting and a unique of most.
Right.
Yeah, thank you for your explanation today.
Alhamdulillah.
And really honored to do this interview with you.
Alhamdulillah.
Yeah, alhamdulillah. So
best of luck. Yeah. Right.
So do you have anything last wish to say to the viewer?
Well, under Islamic Outreach Abim Center, we have 10 masjid and 1 gallery, inshallah, actually, that can allow other faiths to come in and we can share with them the concept of architecture and Islam as well as the whole. So visit the 11 masjid and the 1 gallery through our website and all that. And we also would like to welcome more volunteers, especially who Allah has given you the extra talent to have foreign language, or third language, right? So we are able to speak Japanese, Korean, German, French. By all means, we would welcome you to join us as the volunteers here, right? Yeah, alhamdulillah, inshallah.
Inshallah, that's it. Okay, that's the end of it for this interview.